right, good afternoon, everyone. Let's talk about modularity. Thank you for coming to this session. My name is Milan Jankov. I work for a company called LifeRay and want to reference to some of the new stuff that is going on currently on modularity in Java, particularly referring the JDK 9 early access and what is not so new. So you are familiar with the modularity that's the modularity efforts that are going on in the Java platform, right? Okay, good. So what you may think of as like, hey, it's all new, so what is it that is not new? And by the way, I'm gonna really have to rush through this talk because it's only 15 minutes and I'm kind of trying to squeeze a 1 hour talk into 15 minutes, so get used to that. Some things will not be very clear. I'll try to explain as much as I can, given the time. So when I say not new, what I want you to think is not new in a sense of a concept and not in a sense of a tools. Because obviously everything that comes in a sense of a, like how things are implemented under the hood, it's totally new. No question about that. But concept of modularity and concept of modular Java applications in general, it's at least 15 years old. So in that sense, it's not new. So for those of you who are not really familiar with what is it, the modularity in Java, there's a bunch of JSRs, some of them dating like 2005. But what you mostly be interested in is probably JSR 376, which is what currently is defining their modularity. And then there are a bunch of Java enhancement processes, which I totally am unable to remember which one's doing what. But if you're curious, you can go and check it out. And there is like an enhancement process for making source code modules and all kinds of different things. Essentially, all this together is supposed to bring you the modularity in Java. So, why is this important? Let's look at a Java application, and you may be thinking in different ways, but it's essentially a bunch of classes, packages, and all kinds of things that are linked together, and they do some work. And so, if your application is complex enough, trying to figure out which one connects to which one in which way, it may be a complex thing to do. So that is one way to look at Java application, but essentially you have to look into it in a slightly different way, because essentially what you have is you have the Java platform that has a bunch of relationship between classes and things. And then at the top of that is your application that has some relationship and classes and packages and stuff. And in the middle, and that turns out to be in most cases the biggest part, is a whole bunch of libraries that you use that also introduce all those weird, connections between stuff, right? So obviously you can divide that in different ways, but let's stick with this like simplified approach for a second. So now the question is, if you have this and you want to have a clean modular approach, what do you do? So, long time ago, OSGI said that, well, we'll try to fix that problem. How many of you are familiar with OSGI? Oh, okay, half of the room, that's nice. So, OSGI said, well, let's fix that problem. Let's look into it and then just do something about it. So, at the Java platform level, well, there's nothing we can do. We don't own the platform, or we cannot enforce anything modular in the platform itself, so we'll just leave with whatever it is there. But in everything else that gets loaded on top of that, it's loaded by class loaders. So if we can figure out a clever way to deal with all those class loaders things, then we can actually introduce a dynamic multi-layer modular system that can load classes in a particular way and keep those relationships clean. So we can have a clean modular architecture based on class loaders, based on the basic class loading concepts that everyone else could use. So then we'll introduce a runtime. Then instead of running your application, you're going to be running the runtime, and your application is going to run inside the runtime. But hey, everything's going to be nice and clear. And that's a very good concept. A lot of people are using it until today. The question is, what you do with all those guys in the middle? And here OSGI Alliance said, well, that's easy. Like, modularity is now well-defined, so then everyone should be doing bundles, which is what a module is called in the OSGI world. And if you've been doing OSGI for a while, you know how well that worked. So, obviously, OSGI guys are not in a position to enforce anyone to build anything. So people would just say, well, I don't care about OSGI. Then community's going to be complaining, hey, your artifacts are not bundles. And they're just going to say, okay, let's just make the bundle, put a few more things in the manifest. It's a bundle now. It's totally messed up in terms of relationships and dependencies and everything, but it's a bundle. Okay, and so that led to a point where a lot of people started to believe that OSGI is very complex and very hard. And while the hard part is building modular applications, a lot of people were just like, oh, no, don't do OSGI because it's very hard. So now, when Java is facing the exact same problem, well, it's going to be a surprise to a lot of people to understand that actually the modularity is the hard part and not the OSGI. But let's look into how Java's going to try to solve that problem. So the Java guys are in a different position. Java platform is something that belongs to them, so they can do whatever they want. So they said, well, we'll make the modules first-class citizens, which totally makes sense for modularizing the Java platform itself. And then what you're going to, and it would be, my opinion, all perfect if they would just stop here. But no, they said that, well, now that we have that, you will have modular applications because, you know, it's modularity in place. Now your application is just going to be using modules, right? And what about the libraries in between? Well, they will be using modules, right? So all of a sudden, you're kind of forced to do modules. Well, you're not really forced because you still can do dash classpath and just run Java the way it runs now. But if you really want to follow up, well, you kind of have no choice. And that's actually a good thing, if you think about it, because now you don't have the option. You have to go with modules sooner or later. So if you look at that picture, that's basically what did not change conceptually. What is new is underneath, is the Java platform, now it's modular, great thing. And then everything above that is actually not new in terms of concept. You would be, you could do modular applications without Jigsaw earlier. It just, a lot of people didn't want to. So that's gonna change now, conceptually. And what's gonna happen is, a lot of people will realize that their applications are not as modular as they think they are. And if you don't trust me, I suggest you to subscribe to the mailing list of Java 9 and see what all these guys that are building frameworks are saying there. But let me have another approach on that real quick. So we kind of have a thinking how you build applications is how you build like real products. So you have a product, before it becomes a product, there is an intermediate product and then another and then you go down to whatever is the materials that build those products. So that's kind of our perception of building applications as well. The only difference is, once you build a product, like you build a, what is it on the slide, shoe, well, it's built. If you want to change that shoe, you want to have a different color, well, essentially you throw it away or build it one more time. That's with product, and that's not how software works. Okay, but that simplifies things. So let's say you want to build this robot thing. Then you will need a lot of things to build it. You will probably need software. You will be needing some computers. You will be need some parts, some tools, all kinds of things. And there will be someone providing those to you, essentially a company or a vendor or a person or whatever. So, but then again, they also, in order to do stuff, need some other stuff from someone else. And so you can think of it as a graph. And because you want to make things simple, and that's what you're going to be hearing from a lot of people that's going to claim that modularity in Java is basically very, very simple, you kind of think of it like a non-cycled graph. So you don't have a bidirectional, you don't have circles, you don't have like cross references in that graph. That makes things a lot more simpler. Which is obviously not how things work in life, because it's perfectly fine that I have a tool, someone else have a tool, and we meet, and we only together can do something. That's a perfectly fine situation, but in software development, you can call that circular dependency and claim it bad, right? So circular dependencies are bad, so we're trying to think to keep this thing simple. So now that you have this, it's like transferring one-to-one to software architecture, so you have artifacts, which are modules, and they provide you with some functionality. And that's very basic concept, so let's just follow it and see how that worked in the past and how it's supposed to be working now. So the first thing is to define the artifact. So an OSGI artifact is basically a jar file with a little bit of meta information that you put in the manifest MF file, and that creates you a module. In JSR 376, you could either have a jar file or you could have a JMOD, and all the meta information about the module is put into a module info Java file that is compiled. Different approach, pretty much the same thing. It just defines some metadata about the module. Now, the module is the thing that provides you something, and it needs to tell you what is it providing to you. And that is what modules export. So, again, in OSGI, you basically would say export package, and in GSR 376, you use exports. It's pretty much the same thing, just get a package and export it. Okay, so the next thing is the flip side of that. So your module consumes something that some other module provides. Now, let me go the other way around this here, this time here. Like GSR tells you that you require a module. And this concept has been around in OSGI for a very, very long time, and it's called require bundle. So essentially, you require some other module. And it's proven to be a bad design over the years. That's why these days, everyone's gonna tell you, if you do OSGI, you import packages instead. You don't depend on modules. And to demonstrate that, you can think of it as like, what is really that you depend on? It's basically, if you need a power plug, you can say, I need a power plug. I don't care who gives me a power plug. I need a power plug. That is the concept of OSGI. Now, in GSR 376, you say, I need this company because I know this company produces power plugs, and it's the only company in my environment that produces power plugs. Now, it may seem similar. It may seem that you can design around it, but there's a fundamental difference. The first case scenario, the information about what you need is in the software. In the second case scenario, information is in your head. You're basically saying, I need that module because I, not the system, I know that this module provides this functionality, right? So that's not documented anywhere in the system, your knowledge, right? So that's a fundamental difference, but both concepts, again, are available in both frameworks. So the second thing is kind of the concept of resellers. So basically, you use something, but that something uses something else, and you need to make sure to have the access to that another something as well, right? So in modular Java, you would have requires public, which is essentially is gonna tell, hey, I'm using that other thing, so now you can use it. And in OSGI, you have this thing called uses clauses. So as you can see, it's very similar. It's exact same thing, basically just written differently. And so the last concept I wanna think is services. So again, it's not only about things, but it's also services. So services is like a huge subject in OSGI. You have the service registry, can register services, look for services, use filters and all kinds of things. In GSR 376, you can basically use a service loader, which is a concept that's been in Java for, the last several releases. And the only difference now is you define those services in the modules instead of manifest files as in a jar files as it used to be before. So as you can see, conceptually, everything that Java 9 is gonna offer you in terms of building modular application, not talking about the platform, but applications on top of that, it's been there for ages. You could have been using that long, long time ago if you wanted to. What I didn't mention, because I didn't have time for that, is Dynamism, obviously, huge changes, versions, layers, support for Java Enterprise Edition, tools, and many other things. So there are fundamental differences as well, but the basic concepts are quite similar. So finally, one thing that I kind of like is a lot of people tend to believe that actually what's going on is a good thing, because when people start using Java 9 with modularity, they soon figure out how limited it is, and then they all of a sudden going to switch to OSGI. And honestly, I wish that was the case, and I want to hope that this is how things will turn out, but I'm not that naive. I know that that's not going to happen. Essentially, if you're not forced to use modules for whatever reason, you're going to be just doing dash class path, and you're going to be just running Java the way you used to run it for the last 10 years. Because if you didn't care for modularity for 10 years, there's no reason for you to care about it right now. So that's obviously my personal opinion on that. So time to close up. One last thing I want to show you is we are organizing this DEF CON thing. And it's a company, like a product-related conferences, so if you never heard of LifeRay, probably never been on your radar. What we're doing different this year is there's going to be a dedicated track for talks, dedicated for modularity, Java modularity, OSGI, and all these things. So if that's something that relates to you somehow, feel free to attend just for the purpose of those track. You can track the conference details on the URL. Okay, so we're out of time, so thank you. Thank you for joining. I don't think we have time for questions, but just come around, I'll be here if you want to ask something. Otherwise, enjoy Sven Peter's closing note. Thank you.